Test.
I think we're good.
Welcome in, ladies and gentlemen, live inside the Daytona Ice Arena as we get set for tonight's lone hockey game of the night between the Florida Gulf Coast University Eagles and your hometown Embry-Riddle Golden Eagles. Alongside me tonight is Andrew Caputo. I'm Nick Gimble. We'll have the call tonight here at Daytona Ice Arena for this ACHA matchup. Andrew, you said you had a little bit of a scouting report on Gulf Coast. Let's hear it.
Happy to be here, and yes, I do. I have a little bit of information on FGCU. They're an incredibly storied team. They consistently compete for the national title, and it's going to be a big test for the Eagles. You know, stepping into this new conference, this is the arguably the best team in the conference, and they will look to showcase that tonight in their season opener.
Something a little bit different that the ACHA does. They go from their 10-minute warm-up straight into the national anthem and the starting lineups. So we'll go ahead and send it down to ice level as it looks like we're set for our starting lineups. Looks like Nico Prulier is going to get the start for Embry-Riddle. He has a 1-2 record with a 4.20 goals against average and a .892 save percentage. He has been the main starter throughout the season. Embry-Riddle coming into this game with 5 games played, a 2-3-0 overall record. 4 points on the season, 13 goals for, 23 goals against, and they have a pretty respectable power play at 13.16%. Could be a little bit higher, but it does mean that they are getting on the board when they are up a man on the ice, and their penalty kill is something to note. 81.25%, a very strong penalty kill. Special teams is going to be a big one in this game, and we will try to send it down to ice level. We'll see if we can hear it as it gets underway.
Yeah.
crowd is into it tonight.
Beautiful rendition of tonight's national anthem by Embry-Riddle's own Michaela Burns and the entire capacity crowd here at the Daytona Ice Arena. Starting for Florida Gulf Coast in number order is going to be number 3, Kyle Horvat. Number 18, Shane Matruska. Number 20, Max Mullallin. Number 25, Alfonso Diaz. Number 28, Craig Fitzgerald. And getting the start between the pipes for Florida is going to be number 30, Michael Kirch. On the opposite end of the ice, it's going to be number 14, Wyatt Ebner, Alex Faller, Brendan Barger, Ryan Marks, Jordan Shepard, and as I mentioned earlier, Nico Prullier gets the start in goal for Embry-Riddle.
This first line for the Eagles has been working magic throughout the year. This Ebner, Faller, Marks line has been had a lot of good chemistry, had a lot of good looks. I believe that Ebner's put a few in this year, and we should be hoping that it continues tonight.
As you were saying, looking at my points here, Wyatt Ebner has one goal and one assist on the season. All the way down at the bottom of my number chart, Jordan Shepard, 4 goals and 2 assists, equaling Ryan Marks, who also has 4 goals and 2 assists. They are in a points race to top this Eagles squad. Embry-Riddle in their home white uniforms with the ERAU lettering across the torso. Blue shoulders and pants will be moving left to right across your computer screen as we are underway. Florida Gulf Coast will have the first possession in their road blue uniforms, mimicking the Vancouver Canucks uniforms with the green stripes on the waist and the elbows. Huge collision down low as Ryan Marks establishes his presence early, and a shot came right in from Faller, and it was steered away from the first save by Kirch. Shot from the blue line by Barger gets deflected up. Hopefully deflected, either that or he pulled it with his 9-iron all the way up into the netting.
Having a little chat with the refs about that one.
We'll see where they put this faceoff, looking like we need an extra puck already just 24 seconds in. Faceoff will stay in the Embry-Riddle offensive end. I apologize if I stumble upon my words. We have Florida Gulf Coast University Eagles versus the Embry-Riddle Eagles. I will try to keep that separated for everyone at home as best I can. Florida has possession in their own zone off the faceoff. Can't get it out. Embry-Riddle with a shot in and a right pad save routinely made. Puck is bouncing in the crease and it gets steered to the near side corner. Pass off the outside of the net. Still bouncing along back there, and Florida will have a chance to clear. They throw it off the boards, but not without some punishment along the half wall. Embry-Riddle with it in their own zone. Tries to throw it off the far side boards. Does so, but only to a pair of blue jerseys in the Florida Gulf Coast defensive end. Connor Black has some trouble with it for Gulf Coast, and Barger is able to send it into the Florida defensive zone. Gulf Coast with a chance to get it out on their breakout. They get it out, and here's a 2-on-1 for Florida. They go to the far side, quick shot and a save right into the midsection of Prullier, and he gives up no rebound on the play.
Good start for the Embry-Riddle Eagles. A lot of good pressure, sustained. Got a few shots in on there, but got to be careful in the pinching there. Don't want to give up too many odd man situations against this FGCU team. They are deadly.
If Gulf Coast wants any chance in this first period, they got to pop one in soon. Like I said earlier, capacity crowd here as a shot from the blue line is left padded away by Prullier. Pass out in front, loose in the crease, and Prullier pounces on the rebound. It was loose in the crease, and he found it long enough for a whistle. This has been a common theme this season here at home for Embry-Riddle. This is now their second consecutive sellout game. And Florida Gulf Coast with another faceoff win in the Embry-Riddle defensive zone. At the blue line, a shot comes in, and it's sticked up into the netting by Prullier. That shot came off the stick of Jacobo Perez on the near side blue line. Faceoff will stay on the near side circle in the Embry-Riddle defensive zone. Jake Vareau will win it back for Gulf Coast, and a shot gets fanned on. Embry-Riddle is unable to clear it out. Gulf Coast keeps it in, throws it in front, but it gets deflected behind the net. Florida tries to throw it to the high slot. A shot comes in, and it's loose in the crease, and a stick from behind off the stick of Marek Sezitsky. That one looked like it was rolling in behind Prullier, and Sezitsky was there to steer it to the far corner. We remain scoreless 2 minutes into the first period, and a pass gets deflected out into the neutral zone. Riddle will send it right back in on the delayed offsides. Kirch sets it up for his defenseman back behind the Florida net. Touch pass into the middle, and there you were saying, Andrew, the bad pinches. Luckily, it's only a 2-on-2 back the other way. Florida with a shot right into the midsection of Prullier, and once again, He has to make another save as Gulf Coast now has a little bit of the momentum.
Coulier has looked sharp this these first few minutes of the third, or the first. Goodness.
That'll bring the clock down to 17:48 left in the first. Shots already 5-1 in favor of Florida Gulf Coast. Emory Riddle had the quick legs on the first shift, but it's been all Gulf Coast since then.
Third line for the Eagles out there, Emory Riddle.
Florida will once again, I believe that's the fourth or fifth consecutive faceoff win in the Emory Riddle defensive zone. That was won by Florida. Riddle with possession will chip it out into the neutral zone. It'll get deflected. Icing is waved off. Emory Riddle with a strong forecheck that'll force Florida to the near side corner. They'll throw it off the boards. And not wanting to get steamrolled by Ryan Knapp was the Gulf Coast captain. And now the crowd starting to get rowdy here, wanting something big to happen. Solomon's taken down on the play. Florida will come back into the Riddle zone. Shot gets sticked away to the far corner. Gulf Coast has possession in the far side. Battling hard with a couple of white jerseys. Two-a-side battle. Both white jerseys are down. Gulf Coast has possession. They look at the blue line, maintains possession, throws it in front, sent out to the blue line, unable to get out. Comes to the near side looking for Hartman. Hartman will rim it around to the far side, and it's on the stick of Malcolm. Malcolm will send it back down low for Lundqvist. It's passed out in front. Pad save is made by Prulier. And again, he will hang on for a whistle.
What a battle in front between Ryan Knapp and the FGCU center there. That was quite a good job of him clearing the crease in front of Prulier.
As you were saying, this Florida Gulf Coast University Eagles team, national title contenders year in and year out, and Emory Riddle looking to make their mark in this new conference. They're battling hard, but they got to get something going, and that's not going to get it done. Gulf Coast finds the back of the net, and you can only expect Nico Prulier to make so many saves on one-timers. That one looked like he was going to skate behind the net to the near side, and a pass came out the far side, and it was one-timed in over the left pad of Prulier, and Florida Gulf Coast will lead 1-0. 16:33 left in the first period.
Looks like Cross is there hyping up the crowd a little bit. Seems to be enjoying that.
Emory Riddle with possession off the ensuing faceoff at center ice. Stolen right back by Florida, and they'll send it into the Riddle defensive zone. Hooking play behind the net, not looking like it's going to get called. The Emory Riddle bench up in arms wanting a call. They're not going to get it. Once again, Florida with possession. Another behind-the-back pass, tries to throw it in front. They don't have a pass in the slot, but they keep it in the Riddle defensive zone. Emory Riddle one more time unable to get it out of the zone. And Barger will give a cross-check to the Florida Gulf Coast player coming in on Prulier, who covered up the puck for a faceoff. 15:59 left in the first period. That sees Florida Gulf Coast leading by a score of 1-0. And leading 9-1 in the shot category. And finally, Emory Riddle will win a faceoff in their own zone. They'll battle for it on the near side corner, right at the goal line. Puck squirts out into the slot, and it's steered to the safety of the far side boards, where Fowler takes a check right on the leg. Good to see him get back up, as that could have been an awkward hit that sent him down. Collision here as I believe that's Ryan Mark sending his man down, and a pass comes out to the blue line, kept in at the blue line, but Florida Gulf Coast will catch that puck and gain Riddle ice. That's going to be Cody Tremblay, who has it back behind the net for Florida. Ryan Marks will pick it up for Emory Riddle. He throws it over the short glass and out of play. Emory Riddle will not be allowed to make their line change.
Good to see the Eagles, the Emory Riddle Eagles, finishing their checks. That's something Coach Joyce is talking about day in, day out, in practice, in all games, in all situations. Always finish your checks.
15:20 left in the first. Crowd trying to come to life on a couple of hits by that top line, but possession has all been had by Florida Gulf Coast, and now the officials are really cracking down on these helmet straps. And maybe the loose chin straps on these Florida Gulf Coast players. That's the second player that's been talked to in the first 5 minutes by either the one linesman or the two orange band officials. Florida Gulf Coast again possession off the faceoff. Shot gets blocked at the blue line by Marks. Gulf Coast still has possession. They'll send it back behind the net of Pruliere. Marks will gather it in the near corner for Embry-Riddle. Throws it up the boards. Again kept in, but on a crazy carom up in the air. Here comes Embry-Riddle down the ice. Here's Chris Barton. He fires a shot that was stopped by the stick of David Cross. And Gulf Coast will chip it out into the neutral zone. A bad pinch by Jordan Shepard in a 2-on-1 for Gulf Coast. And a shot gets deflected up by the stick of Ben Malczewski. Good play on the 2-on-1 there from Malczewski. Didn't get too far to the near side to allow a pass, but as soon as that shot came on, he was able to deflect it up into the netting. Embry-Riddle off the faceoff win will rim it hard around the far side boards. Riddle will get it out. They got a 2-on-1 down the far side. Here comes Sakala. Sakala backhanded in front, sticked away to the far corner by Kirch. That was Ryan Knapp who was escaping to the near side post, and the puck was unable to reach him. Once again, a two-a-side battle for the puck along the boards. It'll squirt to the near side. Gulf Coast has it, but it's in the Zamdor entrance that always has trouble for players trying to gain possession. Gulf Coast will get it out to the neutral zone under the possession of Lundqvist. Lundqvist a drop pass. He fires a shot. Loose puck in the high slot. One-timer gets shouldered away by Pruliere. Up into the netting and out of play. .14:05 left in the first period.
Riddle defense has to be careful in backing up too much and letting these FGCU forwards walk in and take high-quality chances on Nico.
It's a little bit of give and take in there, too. You got to respect the speed, but you don't want to give them too much room. It's a fine line there. Gulf Coast with possession in the neutral zone off the faceoff. Solomon forces him to the far side, but he cuts right into the slot, and a pass comes in. Deflected up to the blue line, goes far side for Hartman. He fires a shot, pad save, rebound, covered up by Pruliere. Faceoff should stay on the far side circle, but again, it's going to be in Embry-Riddle territory. Shots now 11-3 in favor of Gulf Coast. Embry-Riddle with possession off the faceoff in their own zone. They'll settle it down behind the net. They'll pass it to the near side. They got a play to the far corner in the Gulf Coast zone. Doesn't reach the goal line. Play continues. Solomon finishes his man. Puck into the high slot, looking for a shot. None was had there, so they're going to have to battle for possession on the near side. Gulf Coast will rim it around to the far half wall. They'll backhand it out, and another 2-on-1. Here comes Matruska. Matruska comes near side. Back for Matruska. Loose in the crease, and Pruliere will hop on it as Brendan Barger made a diving play on the 2-on-1. He was able to stop that pass with his left hand before it got all the way, and Pruliere was able to pounce on the rebound again.
Excellent dive block by the captain.
But as you were saying, the defenseman getting caught on those plays, trying to pinch at the blue line. That's the third 2-on-1 in the past 3 or 4 minutes. Gulf Coast keeps it in the zone. It was a poor clearing attempt off the stick of Embry-Riddle. Collision back behind the net forces the puck out to the far side half wall, and they'll send it out into the neutral zone, but it's under the possession of Tom Rama. Cycles away from his man, but he turns right back into Embry-Riddle for check pressure. He'll send it around the boards. Near side, Perez takes a check, moving it back far side. And Gulf Coast will get it out. Stretch passes on the tape. Here comes Gulf Coast. A backhand shot stopped by a back check, and the rebound out into the high slot gets deflected to the near corner. Again, another collision on the near side. And this Gulf Coast team is taking quite a beating here from this Embry-Riddle line. And now a player from Gulf Coast that fell down at the same time the Embry-Riddle player went to hit him. I believe they're going to give him a head contact penalty or something like that.
Looks like it's going to be means on that one.
And now the officials are going to gather. We'll see what they get. As I said, what I saw was the Gulf Coast player fall down at the same time the Embry-Riddle player went to hit him, and his hands may have caught him in the head, but only because the Gulf Coast player fell. We'll see what the officials call. It looks like 2 minutes is up on the board.
Mean seems to disagree with the call, and so does the Embry-Riddle bench.
Faceoff will be in the Embry Riddle zone. Just a 2-minute minor power play, or a minor penalty rather, for Embry Riddle. And it's going to be a power play for Florida Gulf Coast. The first power play of the game for either team. As I said, we're going to get to see this 81.25% penalty kill in action for Embry Riddle.
Riddle really needs to kill off this penalty.
At the blue line, it's going to be crossed to settle it down for Gulf Coast. And a pass trying to be forced on the far side. And Ryan Marks steals it away. Here comes Fowler. He's tripped on the play. And it'll be touched up by David Cross. Crowd and the Embry Riddle players looking for a penalty shot, but it was not a clear enough breakaway for a penalty shot. So that'll be the end of the Gulf Coast power play. Just 13 seconds in, it'll be 4-on-4 play for the next 1 minute and 47 seconds.
Great forechecking work by the Marks-Fowler combo there to really draw that penalty.
And they're gonna stay out here for this faceoff in the Gulf Coast zone. Marks will win it back to the blue line. Here's Ebner with a shot, gets blocked by the shin pad of the Gulf Coast forward. Deflected up the far boards, kept in by Embry Riddle momentarily. And Gulf Coast gets it out, where Barger will send it off the near side boards right at the blue line. Gulf Coast gets it back into the neutral zone. They'll play tennis with it in the neutral zone. It's bouncing back and forth between possession. And it'll be sent all the way down the ice off the glass. This should be an icing play against Gulf Coast, and it will be called. With 11:40 left in the first period, 1:20 left in a 4-on-4, and then a 13-second power play will be in the works for Embry Riddle. And now it looks like a pane of glass is out behind the Embry Riddle netminder Prulier on our left-hand side of the ice, and it'll be a timeout called by the officials and the rink staff.
Seems to be a tradition at a Daytona Ice Arena to have at least one pane of glass malfunction.
At least one pane of glass at least once a weekend, I've seen. With two juniors teams and one college team, a lot of bodies flying around into these boards, and the glass just can't seem to hang on.
It's a good opportunity for Riddle to take a breath, decompress, and realize that they are skating with this team and that they can keep with them.
Both teams look to be evenly matched speed-wise, but Embry Riddle definitely has the physicality part. How much is that physicality going to play into the latter part of this game, getting into the final minutes of the third period?
Oh, it'll be huge. I mean, it'll definitely test the conditioning of the FGCU Eagles, see if they can weather that storm, because the Eagles definitely know that this team has a lot of talent, so they don't have to play a system, work hard, and finish those checks, play blue-collar hockey in order to stay with them.
Face-off in the Gulf Coast zone will be won by Florida, sent all the way down the ice off the far boards. It will not go for an icing. Embry Riddle with a strong check in the corner, but Florida has it in a shot, and it goes in. What a shot from, I believe that's number 23, Jake Vereau. He made it all the way down the ice to beat the icing play, stopped up from an Embry Riddle defender, cut right into the slot and fired it over the left shoulder of Prulier.
Nice short side shot.
Not much you can do there except play the body a little more. Diving for that puck almost on the poke check. And missing it has its consequences. It should stay 4-on-4 here, but the time has come off the clock of Embry Riddle's side. A 4-on-4 even strength goal does not constitute a player coming out of the box, so we'll say 4-on-4. Let's see, there's 1:21 left on the side of Florida Gulf Coast, so there should be 13 seconds less of that on the Embry Riddle side.
Good to see the captains and the veterans of the Embry Riddle team going up to Prulier and giving him some words of encouragement, telling him to hang in there.
Now everybody just kind of waiting around on the ice to get the puck dropped.
The fans are letting their voices be heard.
And all Gulf Coast wants to do is to get this play going and try to keep this crowd quieted down. But one thing I'm noticing is this Florida Gulf Coast team is not playing a very professional style of game. They're allowing the crowd to get into their heads. I've seen four or five players looking up at the crowd, acknowledging them. And when you let a crowd know that they're there, in the minds of the opposing team, they're just going to get louder and louder no matter what the score is. Still 4-on-4 play. Fowler bodies his man in the corner. And Barton is in there for some physical play as well. Now there's some pushing and shoving in the corner. They leave the puck in everybody's feet. It's still there, digging around for it. Finally, it comes out to the blue line where Faller will skate it out into the neutral zone. He gains the red line and dumps it into the Florida Gulf Coast zone. Marks with a good read on that play, intercepts that puck, takes a check in the near corner, and now a penalty is going to be called. Not sure who it's on. I want to say it's on Florida Gulf Coast on that hit.
That's what it looked like.
And on Ryan Marks, it's going to be number 13, Christoph Malcolm, Florida Gulf Coast team captain. He will wear the C for this Gulf Coast team, voicing his displeasure to the official. So it's going to be 4-on-3 on the ice for 30 seconds as Emery Riddle has to get one here to pull back within one. They trail 2-0 with 10:44 left in the first period. Shepard is unable to win that faceoff, and because of that, Florida will send it the length of the ice. Perlier will settle a rolling puck down for Colin Bridges. Bridges back behind his own net will escape out the near side. Gulf Coast smartly giving Riddle as much time as they want in the neutral zone. And it'll be Kyle Juszczyk to take a check, moving the puck to the far side corner in Florida territory. Good stick check from Gulf Coast. They'll get the puck out into the neutral zone, but that's as far as they'll get before the puck gets back on an Embry Riddle blade.
5-on-3 now for the Eagles, or for Embry Riddle.
Shepard comes in over the blue line on sides. Now it's back to 5-on-4. Shepard's taken down on the play, close to a slew foot, knocked down at the blue line. Long shot goes off the outside of the net. On this angle, most of the crowd, and you and I, Andrew, reacted as if that had gone in. New nets here this season for the Daytona Ice Arena, so when it hits any part of the net on the inside, it just sticks right in there, and that's what it looked like, but it went off the outside of the net. Ryan Marks comes in over the blue line, evading a pair of checks, comes down, shoots, and a blocker save is made by Kirch, and he hangs on for a whistle. And now a little bit of extracurricular activities in the Gulf Coast crease. And just as I was saying that Gulf Coast looks to be a little bit distracted by the crowd, it looks like Embry Riddle is distracted by Florida Gulf Coast. I was looking at the defenseman for Florida getting pushed around in the crease, and he was not reacting. He basically wanted Ryan Marks to go after him, try to draw a penalty, which is smart for Florida. But as Embry Riddle players have to recognize, Florida's going to try to get them off their game, try to keep them on a 5-on-4 penalty kill, because that's where Gulf Coast will shine. Rimmed around the far side boards, kept in by Embry Riddle, thrown into the corner, bouncing puck is settled down by Florida, rimmed around, bounces around off the boards, and Gulf Coast will skate it out shorthanded. Coming in over the blue line, he knocks his man down. I believe that was Ebner who took a tumble, and now a loose puck in the crease, and it's going to be roofed over the shoulder of Perlier, and Gulf Coast has a shorty to make it 3-0. Looks like that comes off the stick of number 3, Kyle Horvath. He leads the line through the handshakes around the bench. 9:13 left in the first, and that shorthanded goal gives Gulf Coast a 3-0 lead. Still 30 seconds left for Embry Riddle to try to get a power play goal. Gulf Coast loses it at the blue line, loose there, and Solomon has it in the near half wall. Pass in front into the glove of Kirch, and he read that well. He was ready for that pass coming in, and he gloves it right down for a whistle. Faceoff will stay on the near side. Looks like they're going to try to win it back to Barger at the blue line.
He's been known for his large slap shot.
Terrible pass in front. Shot comes in. Rebound loose in the crease. Gets sent behind the net. Solomon bodies his man back below the goal line. Bouncing puck kept in by Barger. He'll send it off the boards. Gulf Coast will send it off the body of Kirsten. And Gulf Coast will send it to the far side. We're back to 5-on-5 play. Tremblay down the far side, tries to cut in, but a good defensive play, and now a pass in front, gets stick back behind the net by Perlier. Embry Riddle trying to get it out of danger. They'll send it up the boards. And back the other way will come Solomon. He takes a slap shot, that's stopped by a stick. of number 25, Alfonso Diaz.
Ooh.
That will allow Florida to gain the neutral zone. And this is going to be a slashing penalty against Embry-Riddle. It was the back official who saw it. You and I saw it. You made a sound on it. You saw the slash behind the play, and so did the official. And as I was saying, Florida Gulf Coast is going to start trying to get Embry-Riddle off their game. And it works here for, it looks like, a high sticking penalty against Ben Solomon.
That's a tough call there by Solomon. Tough play to make there. It's going to be a tough penalty kill here, especially with how much momentum Gulf Coast has already gotten.
8:07 left in the first period. That sees Gulf Coast already leading by a score of 3-0. 14-5 shots in favor of Florida. They have possession on their power play. Pass up to the blue line. Slap shot gets deflected. Pad save made by Perlier. Rolling puck is settled down at the top of the near circle by Florida. Saucer pass gets deflected by Usiak. He tries to chase it down in the neutral zone. And Gulf Coast will settle it back behind their own net, away from white jersey pressure.
Smooth breakout by Gulf Coast here, goodness.
Not a lot of pressure coming from Embry-Riddle until they finally get over the Embry-Riddle blue line. No white jersey decided to make a move until they got over the blue line, and because of that, a shot comes in on the blue line. Pad save, but another rebound goal from Florida went right through the wickets of Prouliere, and it's now a 4-0 lead for Gulf Coast. Not quite sure how much leash the Embry-Riddle coaches are going to give to Nico Prouliere. And you can't really discredit Prouliere on too many of these goals. There may have been one that nicked his pad a little bit, and it looks like Embry-Riddle is going to call their timeout. But when you look at all the plays, it's been a breakdown either in front. This most recent one, you can only expect your goalie to make the first save. At that point, the rebound has to be cleared out by the defense, and the Embry-Riddle goaltender has just been left out to dry. This timeout will come with 7:26 left in the first period. Shots now 17-5 in favor of Florida Gulf Coast.
Coach Joyce seems to be visible on the bench. He normally is a quiet presence, so it's interesting to see him more animated, trying to bring life into this team.
We got to have some sort of big hit. We got to just get one in the net. We got to get this crowd back into the game, and we got to get Embry-Riddle some momentum here before this period's over. Even if they just get one, make it 4-1, even if Gulf Coast gets one more, having one goal up on the board rather than a big old goose egg is going to have a much better feel for the start of the second period. So we're finally back to 5-on-5 play, first time in a while. We'll have a faceoff at center ice after the power play goal from Florida Gulf Coast, and they will have possession right off the faceoff. An errant pass goes all the way down the ice. It will have the icing waved off. That will allow Fowler to get it out of the zone on the far side. Here comes Embry-Riddle. Ryan Mark sends his man down, cuts into the high slot, fires a shot, and scores! Still 7 minutes and 8 seconds left in this first period. It's been a long period, still got a lot of time to go. And Ryan Mark's trying to do some more, but it gets sent into the Embry-Riddle defensive zone. Usiak will rim it back to the near side boards. Marks loses it at the top of the circle, so it's kept in by Gulf Coast, and they will send it back behind the net. Florida takes a body down low. Ryan Marks doing it all, scoring goals, blocking shots now too, and bodying up players down low. Embry-Riddle has to get it out here, and they do. Maintained under Florida possession. They get around a pair of white jersey forecheckers, and Florida will bring it right back as far as the blue line, poked along and into the Florida zone by Fowler. Fowler with a strong forecheck will force the puck back behind the Gulf Coast net. They'll send a pass, goes to the far side on a nice one-touch, sensing a bit of Embry-Riddle pressure, but it gets turned over to the Embry-Riddle captain Barger, who turns it back over to the Gulf Coast blue line, and here they come over the blue line, and it's an offside play. And that will stop any chance Gulf Coast had on that break-in attempt. 6:08 left in the first period, 4-1 lead. Now for Florida Gulf Coast, one goal on six shots is not a great statistic for Michael Kirch. So you just got to keep putting the puck on net if you're Embry-Riddle. You got to get something going. Gulf Coast with a good regroup out of their own zone. They'll bat it off the paraphernalia of Sizitsky. And Gulf Coast will send it up to the blue line. Onside play. Gulf Coast has it in the Embry-Riddle defensive zone. Barger's going to rim it up the near side boards. Embry-Riddle can't clear it out. Kept in by Gulf Coast below the goal line. Pass in front. Backhanded one more time. Shot. Pad. Save is made by Perlier. Pass in front. Set to the near side by Barger. Barger intercepts that shot and a bouncing puck kept in at the blue line again by Gulf Coast. And it's finally settled down by Brantley Miller. Miller will send a bouncing puck all the way down. And last time we were here, that kind of bouncer went in. So you're going to try every shot you can from everywhere on the ice. Gulf Coast is tripped up on the play by Solomon, or it looked like at least he may have tripped on his own footing. No penalty is going to be called, and here comes Gulf Coast back into the Riddle defensive zone. Barger one-hands it out where Solomon is able to skate it out and takes a tumble doing so. And now Solomon dealing with a late check to the head from number 12, Seth Cohen. That draws the attention of the crowd, and here comes Solomon on a breakaway. He takes a slap shot into the glove hand of Kirch, and he hangs on for a whistle.
Things are certainly heating up in South Daytona.
Solomon was taken down on a clean check on the first hit. It was a very solid shoulder to the chest of Ben Solomon, but it was the follow-through while Solomon was on the ground that got the attention of Solomon and the entire crowd here. And at the end of the shift, Solomon just didn't have enough gas to skate the puck in, and a slap shot went right into the glove hand of Kirch. Face-off, one and a shot goes into the glove hand of Kirch again, and he hangs on for another whistle. Shots now 17-8 in favor of Gulf Coast still, but Embry-Riddle feeling that life, feeling the crowd behind them. They're getting more and more shots, and their shot total has doubled in the past 45 seconds to a minute. Gulf Coast will win the faceoff, and a body down low. Silcox sent his man into the board, separated him from the puck. Silcox still with possession, working one-on-two against a pair of blue jerseys. Sent back behind the net to the far side, and Popia is going to send it up the boards, backhanded out to the blue line. Not wanting to get freight trained at the blue line, they just chip it out into the neutral zone. Gulf Coast does, and now on an offside play, this will bring a halt with 4:12 left in the first period. Faceoff will be right in front of the Embry-Riddle bench on the far side of the ice. Gulf Coast wins the faceoff back to their own blue line, and a pass gets deflected, so that will negate the icing. And it'll be Ben Corley who loses possession at the blue line. That will allow Embry-Riddle to get it out into neutral ice. Brought right back in, thrown off the body of Embry-Riddle players left and right, and it will get out where Gulf Coast settles it down at their own blue line, chipped into the zone, foot race, and it gets deflected once again back out into the neutral zone. A late hit there, no call's gonna be made. This is starting to turn into a very physical game, and we have another one to go tomorrow night. Gulf Coast making the line change, so Embry-Riddle will easily gain the red line and dump it into the glove hand of Kirch, and he hangs on for a whistle. That'll bring a faceoff in the Gulf Coast defensive end with 3:26 left in the first.
Gulf Coast certainly not afraid to walk the line with the timing of the hits after a player's released the puck.
If the referees are going to give it to you, they're going to take it. And until the referees start calling it, we're going to see some late hits. We're going to see some stick whacks. And we'll see how long it takes the officials to get this under control before it starts to escalate too far. Usiak dodging, or excuse me, that was Sizitsky who evaded a check on the far side. Now Sizitsky will force a pass to the near side. Gulf Coast has possession in their own zone. They play catch below their own goal line.
This fourth line for the Eagles is the energy line. Definitely a hardworking line of only freshmen. That has definitely impressed Coach Joyce and made an impact in the first five games.
Ryan Knapp has it for Embry-Riddle in his own zone. Sends it up the near side, intercepted by Gulf Coast, and they'll rim it back below Perlier. Thrown off the outside of the net. Gulf Coast trying to walk it into the middle. A backhand shot didn't miss by much, went just past the near side post as the crowd starts to get a little louder as this clock winds down to 2:35 left in the first. At the blue line, Gulf Coast can't keep it in. A good shot block at the blue line. And now an offside play as this one came in right to the skates of Malcolm before he could exit the zone. We'll bring a faceoff, 2:28 left in the first period. That'll bring the faceoff back at center ice where the pass originated from. Gulf Coast will have possession off that faceoff and they'll gain Embry-Riddle ice. Horvath sends it into the middle, deflected, and Perlier may have gotten a stick on it to force it to the far side. Pinching down on the blue line is Rama. He didn't get it, gets it at the blue line now. Sends it far side, deflected into the midsection, and Perlier hangs on.
Almost a little friendly fire on that tip there by Embry-Riddle forward.
Perlier has definitely settled into this game. He's already got, he's on pace now for 60 shots in this game.
A little fun fact for you, Nick, is that the last time we played these teams, they rang over 90 shots in each game we played them. In fact, in the last game that me and Perlier played together, I think it was 109 shots on record.
And there's another one that comes right into the elbow of Perlier. No rebound given up there, and that takes the shot total to 20. Still 2:04 left in this first period. Embry-Riddle only has 9 shots, and they trail 4-1. On the scoreboard. Embry-Riddle trying to dig it out of some feet and they get it out into neutral ice. Usiak is unable to maintain possession for Embry-Riddle and it's thrown out into the neutral zone by Gulf Coast. They'll regroup in their own zone off the stick of Perez, comes near side for Rama. Rama will gain the red line and dump it down the glass. Hits a stanchion and comes right back where Embry-Riddle will send it all the way down. Here's Usiak working on a two-on-two. Gets around his man. Fires a shot off the mask, I believe. And now the goaltender, Kirch, is calling for a whistle, and he'll get it. It looked like it went off the mask of Kirch, and it did.
Usiak doing his best to welcome Kirch to the game.
1:32 left in the first period, and you got to do what you got to do to get a goalie off his game, even if that means ringing one right off of his clock, right between the eyes.
Speaking from the experience of being a goalie, it's definitely changes the rest of the game when you take one right between the eyes, for sure.
Off the faceoff, Marks wanted to send it right through the legs of his opposing centerman. Here comes Gulf Coast back the other way. A backhand shot. Pad save made by Perlier. Embry-Riddle looking for a counterattack. Shepard comes in over the blue line, falls down, coming in over that blue line, and it comes all the way out into neutral ice. Comes in a long shot, gloved down by Kirch, and he will drop it for his defenseman. Comes off the boards. Thrown high off the glass, and here's another two-on-one for Gulf Coast. Goes to the far side, takes the shot wide of the far side post. Under a minute to go here in this first period. Here comes Jordan Shepard. Shepard loses it at the blue line, and Marks will backhand it at the blue line, and it will gain Gulf Coast territory for a second, and it comes back out into neutral ice. Florida comes into the Riddle zone, pass in front, shot, and a collision there. Sent number 12, that was Seth Cohen, down to the ice. Embry-Riddle trying another counterattack, but they're stopped at the red line. And here they come back again. Daniel Sakala, his toe drag fails, and he has to chip it into the near corner with 20 seconds to go in the period. Embry-Riddle in the midst of a line change. That will allow Gulf Coast to get it to the blue line, but as far as that, and a good shot block in front by Papilla forces the puck out into the neutral zone with 9 seconds to go. One last chance for Riddle, and they'll just send it right in on goal, gloved down, and Kirch will send it out into the neutral zone, and that'll be the end of the first period of play. Shots 21-12 in favor of Florida Gulf Coast, and they also lead 4-1 on the scoreboard. Andrew, what seems to be the most promising factor for Embry-Riddle as they head into the first intermission, down by 3?
Well, I think probably one of the best things to say is that you came out of a period and you played toe-to-toe with one of the best teams in the country. There's definitely a lot to be said in that regard. They had their chances, absolutely. They They had a few shots, and they made some hits and had some plays where they had FGCU on their heels. But absolutely have to watch on the pinching. There's been a lot of odd man situations, and if FGCU hit the net one or two more times, you know, this could be a 5-6-1 game. But definitely a lot of positives to take out. There's still 40 minutes of hockey left to play. The Brutal Eagles could easily get back into this game.
And I tell you what, in between these next couple of periods, someone's going to have to go buy Nico Prulier a Gatorade or two in the lobby. And if he keeps this up, someone's going to have to buy him a very nice dinner tonight. He's standing on his head. He's the only reason Embry Riddle's still in this game.
It's always been a credit to Embry Riddle is their solid goaltending depth. It's often a difficult choice for Coach Joyce to choose who he puts in between the pipes.
We will be back for the start of the second period here at the Daytona Ice Arena shortly. But you ain't gonna find it around. It's the same old story, same old song and dance, my friend. It's the same old story, same old story, same old song and dance. Welcome back, ladies and gentlemen, live inside the Daytona Ice Arena as we get set for the start of the second period here between the visiting Florida Gulf Coast University Eagles and the hometown Embry-Riddle Eagles. Florida Gulf Coast is going to come into the second period leading by a score of 4-1 and leading 21-12 in the shot category. Andrew, what has to be the biggest change for Embry-Riddle coming into this second period on a fresh sheet of ice?
I definitely think pinching is going to be huge. I think the D are going to have to they're going to be active, but they're going to have to be careful in those plays because this team is a team that does not miss chances often. And at the same time, it's going to be has to be complemented by the forwards coming back. They're going to have to come back and help the D out, back check hard, and find their defensive roles when FGCU gets their surges, because they will.
Special teams, the name of the game in the first period. Florida Gulf Coast scoring in every situation. 4-on-5, 5-on-4, and 5-on-5. They picked up a shorty, a power play, and they dominated most of the game on even strength.
Looks like Shepard's being put back with this first line. 9 goals combined between Marks and Shepard this year, so we'll see if they that scoring touch can be found again, as Marks has already found it.
No change in goaltenders. It's going to be Nico Prouliere to remain in between the pipes for Embry-Riddle. And Florida Gulf Coast is going to come right in on him, and a blocker save made by Prouliere deflects to the near side corner. Gulf Coast moving left to right across your computer screen. Embry-Riddle moving in the opposite direction in their home white uniforms, right to left. Gulf Coast at their own blue line, working on their neutral zone regroup. They'll send it up the far boards, deflected in. Met by 3 white jerseys, and Barger is going to settle it down off the back of his own man, and Gulf Coast will have it in the zone, and it's deflected up to the blue line, unable to be kept in and thrown in on a delayed offsides. Gulf Coast will make a set of line changes. Embry-Riddle looking for a breakout pass, comes off the boards and deflected in. Embry-Riddle will make a 3-man line change. Off the near corner boards, thrown far side, Gulf Coast will throw it in to the Embry-Riddle zone. Battle for possession on the near side corner. Airmail to the far side half wall. Embry-Riddle has a chance to clear it out. They can't do it. Finally, on the second effort, they get it out, but right onto the stick of Florida. Bouncing puck is going to be sent into the Gulf Coast zone, settled down by Michael Kirch, for Gulf Coast. Starting goaltender will allow his team to come up. Pass comes in the near side, a shot didn't miss by much. Prouliere was able to get in position. And now a couple of players coming together in the high slot after the net came off of the pegs behind Prouliere. Everybody will be separated with 18:21 left in a second period.
Prouliere's home was definitely rocked hard. Not sure who ended up taking the net off, so we'll see where the faceoff is.
Looks like everybody set up in the Embry-Riddle zone. I believe it was a Gulf Coast player that was pushed into the net by an Embry-Riddle player. So I believe that will keep the faceoff in the Embry-Riddle defensive zone. No one contesting one way or another. And it looks like the faceoff will stay in the Embry-Riddle zone. No one protesting, so it looks like it is the right call. Gulf Coast will win the faceoff up to the blue line. No shooting lane, so it has to be sent to the near corner. They'll battle for possession. Embry-Riddle is able to get it out into the neutral zone. Rolling puck settled down, almost turned over in the high slot by Barton. And now Gulf Coast will come right back in. They'll catch it off the near boards. Turnaround shot is stopped in front. Backhander cannot get out. Kept by Vareau. Vareau stick handles it down to the near corner. Looking for a passing option is Corley. Corley sends it up to the blue line. A shot gets through, and a skate save had to be made by Prouliere. Florida Gulf Coast trying to get a shot on. Can't do so. It's sent to the far side half wall. Barton is able to pinch his man along the wall, and a puck gets deflected up into the Gulf Coast bench and out of play.
Riddle's been hemmed in their zone most of this period so far, trying to weather this surge from FGCU.
17:27 left in the second period, looking for our first goal of this frame. Both shots in this period belong to the boys in blue. Gulf Coast leading the shot category 23-12. Gulf Coast will win the faceoff in front of their own bench. They'll send it off the boards on a nearly offside play. The linesman was going to call it, but they were able to touch up on the delayed offsides before anything had to be called. Saucer passes on the tape. Gulf Coast trying to maintain possession, can't do so. Embry Riddle will skate it out into neutral ice. Goes far side, looking for the stick of Solomon, went through him. Solomon on a back check sends his man down to the ice, but Gulf Coast maintains possession, back behind the net, looking for a stuff attempt, can't find it, turns and fires off the outside of the net, gets deflected out of play for a whistle with 16:54 left in the second. Faceoff will come to the near side circle in the Embry-Riddle defensive end. Looks like it's going to be Kirsten for Embry-Riddle against Matruska for Florida Gulf Coast in for this faceoff. Referee trying to put a little bit of snow and water to freeze that net down on its peg. It's come off two or three times this period, and we're just over 3 minutes into it.
Kirsten's a solid center for Riddle. He's a hardworking penalty killer, solid on the power play, good two-way guy.
Riddle is unable to clear it. Shot off the mask of Prouliere. He seems to be okay. Referee willing to give him a whistle if he needed it, but play's going to continue. And just as we saw in the first period, that's going to rattle the goaltender's cage, you said, Andrew. A slap shot coming right through will definitely change the mentality of a goaltender. Looks like he is okay in the crease, and he's ready for more action.
Each team getting their lick in on those kind of shots.
And now this will be a hand pass called against Gulf Coast.
Prouliere checking his helmet, making sure it's still on.
Referee also making sure Prouliere and his mask are okay to continue. Faceoff will come, looks like, in front of the Embry-Riddle bench in the neutral zone. 16:23 left in the second. Still 5-on-5 play, no penalties called in this second period. And we will have a false start on this play. And we will restart all over. Riddle tries to skate it in, can't do so. Gulf Coast brings it right back with speed down the far side boards, takes a shot, glove save made by Prouliere. No rebound given up, and we'll have a faceoff in the Riddle defensive zone.
That Gulf Coast speed was definitely on display on that play.
That was Greg Steinmetz, who blew past the Riddle defenseman on the far side and got the shot off, but it went right into the left-handed catcher of Prouliere. Ebner sends it off the near boards. Gulf Coast keeps it in, takes a check doing so, but they send it into the near corner. Ebner will send it back far side for Barger. He'll saucer one out into the neutral zone, out of trouble at least, but it's still on the stick of some Gulf Coast sticks. Gulf Coast back the other way down the near side boards. He will gain the red line and dump it in behind the net. Barger keeps it away from a forechecker, and he will send it out into the neutral zone. Almost too many men on the ice for Gulf Coast, but they stay clear of that. Off the skate of Ebner, he settles it down in his own zone. Backhands a quick pass up. And Silcox has it stolen away by Papilla. Papilla walks into the high slot, fires a shot, glove saved by Prouliere.
Prouliere's glove has been getting a lot of work in the beginning of the second. Goodness.
And that's a tough save for a goalkeeper. A player moving right to left across the high slot. Goalkeeper moving with him from his left to right, and he has to make that lunge back to where he came from to make that glove save. Embry-Riddle finally with a faceoff win in their own zone. They get it out. They got a 3-on-2. Pass into the middle for Faller over the blue line down the near side board. Pass into the middle. Skate It hit the skeet of Popia, and it careemed to the near corner. Faller has it, reverses down low for Marks. Spin move into the middle, shot gets deflected up just over the crossbar. Faller bodies his man on the far side, but Gulf Coast with a nice stretch pass up on the tape for Cohen. Down the near side boards, Cohen gains Riddle ice, sends it into the middle, but it went through the stick of everybody. And Marks will bring it right back the other way. Over the blue line, right down the center. And his shot goes to the far side. Shepard sends it back down low for Marks. He's got Faller in front looking for a stuff attempt and a save made by Kirch. Shepard tries to move it up to the blue line for Usiak. Nothing there. And now the net came off behind Kirch.
Not sure how that net ended up coming off.
I'll tell you how. Goalie tactics. Kirch not getting a lot of action in the first 5 minutes, and he was feeling the pressure and just, oops, my net came off.
I'd be lying if I said I hadn't done that once or twice before.
And now, if the official does his job properly, Gulf Coast should not be allowed to make a line change because it was Kirch who knocked the net off of its pegs without any help from a Riddle player. So Gulf Coast should not be allowed to make a line change. All five blue jerseys are standing around the bench wanting to make a change. And it looks like Gulf Coast is going to try to sneak a couple of changes. Referee not going to let that happen. And not sure what the delay is here. Embry-Riddle waiting by their bench. Gulf Coast by their bench. Not sure what's going on here.
A lot of confusion going on right now. Not sure if there's a painted glass issue. Seems to be the ladder seems to be out.
Ladder is out in the near side corner, and a ladder just went running past us below. And it looks like there is a pane of glass out on the near side corner. On the same end of the ice as the first period, behind the Florida Gulf Coast netminder this period on the near side, and we will have a ladder come out onto the ice for the second time tonight with 14:31 left in the second period. So even though Gulf Coast will not be allowed to make their line change, their referee doing a diligent job of making sure all the right numbers stay out on the ice, but it means nothing if Gulf Coast is able to make this long of a wait before the pane of glass gets set in. You like to think you get home ice advantage, But instances like this where you have a tired group of Gulf Coast players for an offensive zone faceoff, you want to get your top line of fresh legs out, and it just doesn't happen.
Seems to be a give and take with this arena here with a great fan base, great crowd, a lot of energy in this building, but the building often failing us from time to time.
And there have been a lot of improvements in the lobby area and in the locker rooms. They're giving a great facelift to the arena, but... And we can see the lights, too. It's a very well-lit arena now. There used to be a couple of lights out. Every single light working now. Great view of the ice. But I haven't seen any upgrades made to the ice surface or the glass or the boards around it yet.
Definitely seems to be a lot of growing pains going on. Hopefully we can start to see these changes taking place everywhere in the arena soon. But it looks like everyone's squared away. All the pains are in for now, and I guess we're going to drop the puck again.
So, like I said, even though Gulf Coast was unable to make a line change, everybody's fresh and ready to go on the far side circle in Gulf Coast territory. Embry-Riddle will win the faceoff. A one-timer at the blue line just went over the crossbar. A pair of blue jerseys were looking for a stretch pass, and they're going to get it, but it gets deflected away by a step-up of Connor Lapps. On the near side, here comes Cohen. He takes a shot and scores. What a shot over the left shoulder of Prouliere, and Gulf Coast picks up right where they left off. In the first period, they lead 5-1 now, 14-12 left in the second.
That was an excellent shot up in the toy department by Cohen.
Faceoff will come back out to center ice. Once again, a four-goal deficit for Embry-Riddle to try to tie this game up. Still plenty of time, still over half this game to go. And as we were saying in the first period, this physical style of play that Embry-Riddle likes to use will wear down the conditioning of the opposing team, but when we have this many stoppages, it allows the opposing team to regain their composure and their breath So it looked that physical play won't mean too much unless they keep it up and actually keep the pace of the clock moving. Gulf Coast walking right in, and a good stick there from Miller forces the puck to the near side. Comes up to the slot, and a shot went wide of the near side post. Gulf Coast is swarming in the Riddle zone.
Give a lot of credit to Gulf Coast on their smooth puck movement here.
Shot save made on a rebound by Prouliere. He was able to smother up that second effort right into his chest protector for a whistle with 13:28 left in the second. Gulf Coast can smell blood in the Embry-Riddle water right now, and they just want to keep putting pressure on the board right now. Solomon has that puck bounce right over his stick, and that will allow a shot from the far blue line. Sticked away by Prouliere. A pass comes into the middle, and it will get deflected to the far corner. Back near side, tries to throw it in front, can't do so. Gulf Coast maintains possession. Pass comes up to the blue line. Perez with a shot, gets through, off the post and in. Prouliere was screened by a pair of white and blue jerseys.
And looks like Mitchell Kim is coming into the game.
A seeing eye shot. Again, you really can't fault Nico Prouliere on that one.
He had
no sight line, no help in front of him. Yeah, it's a long shot. That's normally routine if he can see it. But if he can't see it, he can't stop it. And as you said, Nico Prouliere will end his night on the sixth goal of the game for Florida Gulf Coast. And Mitchell Kim will be his replacement.
No fault of Nico Prouliere on that. Definitely a solid period and a half of effort.
13:07 left in the second period, 6-1 lead for Gulf Coast. And it doesn't matter what the score is, this crowd is going to be loud. Kim will send it to the near corner for his defenseman. Backhanded up the wall, kept in by Gulf Coast. They'll send it into the middle, and a shot, stick save, rebound covered up, and it will draw a whistle.
A solid first test for Kim and net, and he stands tall on that one. Despite his short height.
12:49 left in the second, 6-1 lead for Florida Gulf Coast. Shots now 31-14 in favor of Gulf Coast. Florida will win the faceoff up the blue line, and a shot gets deflected, gloved down by Kim, and he hangs on for another whistle. Still 5-on-5 play. Faceoff will stay in the Riddle zone. Faceoff won by Gulf Coast. Shot comes in, skated down, but it's given up in the slot, and a shot. Not sure how that one stayed out. I believe it hit the Gulf Coast player that was behind Kim. Either way, it stayed out. And it will bring a whistle with 12:35 left in the second. That'll bring the faceoff out into the neutral zone. In front of the Florida Gulf Coast bench, Embry-Riddle will win it. Ryan Marks has a toe drag that works on one, but it doesn't work on two. Gets some help from Shepard. Shepard down the far side boards, takes a shot, shouldered away by Kirch.
I'd like to see that shot a little bit lower so that Marks could drive in for a rebound.
Gulf Coast trying to work on their breakout. Pass on to the near side is a good one. Comes onto the stick of Lundqvist, and he sends it into the Riddle zone. Strong forecheck separates the Riddle defenseman from the puck, and Gulf Coast sets up on their forecheck. Pass up top, and a one-timer save made by Kim, and a puck still loose in the slot. Another shot blocked in front, this time by Shepard. And Marks will come down the far side boards. Pass into the middle, sticked away at the last second by Craig Fitzgerald on a great defensive play for Gulf Coast.
That was a great, potentially goal-saving stick play.
And this centering pass gets sticked away by Kim. And now Gulf Coast, with too many men on the ice, not going to be called by the linesman right in front of him. Over on the far side, comes back up to the blue line, or at least tries to. Good play by Wyatt Ebner to separate his man from the puck. March will body his man down low. That will allow Usiak to rim it off the near side boards. Kept in by Gulf Coast. Shot gets deflected by the stick of Faller, and Embry-Riddle is able to get it out with 11 minutes left in the second period. Pass on the tape for Black. Comes near side, and it's going to be picked up by Diaz. Diaz will take the shot, patted down by Kim, and he will cover up the rebound with 10:55 left in the second. Gulf Coast doubling the shot total for Embry-Riddle. They lead 31-15 in that category.
Riddle has not gotten a lot of offense in this second period, that's for sure.
Halfway through this period, they only have three shots credited in this second frame. Pass to the far side for Rama, walks in, fires a shot over the crossbar. And again, we're going to have a whistle. Not sure if this shot knocked the pane of glass out or if it broke it. I'm not sure which pane it was.
It might have went out of play, too.
Might have gone out of play. I heard it hit the glass. May have deflected out, as you said. We're not going to have a stoppage to fix it, so I guess you're right, Andrew. It just went out of play.
It's tough to see from this corner.
Comes up to the blue line off the faceoff. Gulf Coast has it. Shot gets deflected to the near corner by Miller. At the blue line, Perez sends it back down low. At the half wall, walks and fires. Pad saved by Kim. Rebound settled down. And a toe drag by Gulf Coast. Shot comes in, deflected down by Barger. And he gets it out into the neutral zone for Miller. Miller waiting for reinforcements. Backhands it into the midsection of a Gulf Coast defender. And Barger will settle it down in the neutral zone. At the blue line, he has to wait for Miller to get out, so he has to just dump it into the near corner. Gulf Coast retreats below their own goal line, sets up on their breakout. Pass off the near boards, and a collision there as Brantley Miller sent his man down to the ice.
The energy line out there for Embry-Riddle.
Brendan Barger bodies his man, and now a check into the boards. Gulf Coast proving they have some bodies there too. And it is going to be a hand pass called against Gulf Coast to bring a stoppage of play with 9:47 left in the second.
Embry-Riddle's hoping that a hit like that from Brantley Miller could be the spark to getting them back in this game.
Both teams making some line changes. The faceoff should come out into the neutral zone. It was a hand pass call. Unless there's a new rule that I don't know about that prohibits Embry-Riddle from making a hand pass in the defensive zone now. Well, this shot right off the faceoff comes into the glove hand of Mitchell Kim, and he hangs on. Still a 6-1 goal lead for Florida Gulf Coast over Embry-Riddle.
To answer that hand pass rule, I think I believe hearing that the ACHA has passed a new rule that you are not allowed to make a hand pass anywhere.
And this rolling puck into the top of the crease. Mitchell Kim, close to the ice, is able to snag that one as it rolled right in front of him. Brings the clock down to 9:38 left in the second, over halfway through this game. Gulf Coast with another faceoff win, but Solomon will win the race, and he has possession for Embry-Riddle. Over the blue line on an offside play, after a good back check came from Shea Matruska. That last-minute stick check on Ben Solomon forced him offside, and the faceoff will come on the near side boards in the neutral zone. Pearson wins it back at the red line. It tries to be dumped in, but it's off the shin pad of a Gulf Coast player. That's number 20, Mulholland. And a pass comes back for Mulholland. Settles it down in the neutral zone, and it comes off the near side boards for Papilla to send it in. And over on the far side, Embry-Riddle players tumbling left and right, trying to lay the body on Gulf Coast, but they are able to stay on their feet, getting momentum on their bench. I can hear them more than the crowd at this point, all the way across the ice. And this faceoff will come all the way back down to the Embry-Riddle defensive zone after a clearing attempt hit the roof here at the Daytona Ice Arena. Face off on the far side circle. Blocker hand side of Mitchell Kim.
Silcox wins that back. One of the feisty, hard-nosed forwards for Embry-Riddle.
Gulf Coast tries to walk in off the boards. Comes in at the goal line. Pass in front. Blocker save on a poke check was made. And now a whistle will blow the play dead. After Kyle Usiak had possession in the high slot, he was well on his way out of the zone. And the official decided to blow the play dead for a net that was off of its pegs behind Mitchell Kim.
Looked like the net was just off slightly, which is why Knapp seemed to be upset with the whistle.
So instead of Knapp skating out into the neutral zone and dumping it at the red line, with the official settling the net behind the play, he decided to blow the whistle, and Gulf Coast now has possession again in their offensive zone. They have it in the high slot, rolls off the stick of Lundqvist. He has it again, pass into the middle through the legs of Steinmetz, and he settles it at the blue line. Pass in front, deflected, pad save, unable to be covered up by Kim, but sent out of the middle of the ice. Gulf Coast with another shot right into the slot. High stick is going to be waved down. Embry-Riddle trying to gain the red line and put it into the Gulf Coast zone. Finally they do, but it's still under Gulf Coast possession. On the far side, Fitzgerald gets it down into neutral ice. Settled down by Knapp.
Laps had it.
Laps will send it off the stick of Usiak into the Gulf Coast zone. Rimmed around the boards. Embry-Riddle has to be careful of too many men on the ice. Huge collision on the far side will allow Marks to settle the puck down at the blue line around a pair of blue jerseys. Toe drag works on his man. He has the puck in the near corner. Pass in front through the crease up top for Shepard. And it was a bouncing puck on him, and that's Ryan Knapp, missed his check, and here comes Gulf Coast, walks into the slot, looking for a shot. Patience pays off as Mitchell Kim was unable to get to his left, and Gulf Coast extends their lead to 7-1.
Tough play there for Kim. His laps forced his defender wide, and he lost control of the puck, but he was able to gain it again and throw it into a yawning cage.
I believe it was Cody Tremblay who may have wanted to get a shot off in the high slot right in the middle of the ice. Kim was following him, but he waited just long enough to put it into a wide open 6x4 after Kim had fallen down trying to stay with the play. Still only three shots for Embry-Riddle credited this period, shots 35-15 in favor of Gulf Coast. Now a 7-1 lead with 7:30 left in the second period. Embry-Riddle wins the faceoff and they will send it into the Gulf Coast defensive end. Marks finishes his man back behind the net after Gulf Coast will send it out into the neutral zone. Backhand is stopped by the skate of Embry-Riddle and a huge collision there. Marks sent down two blue jerseys and Embry-Riddle will come back on a partial 2-on-1. Faller down the left wing boards, toe drag works on his man, cuts into the middle, loose puck in the crease, goes over the crossbar. Shepard can't hang on to it, so it gets under Florida possession. Rolling puck along the dasher will be settled down by Gulf Coast. At the blue line, intercepted by Barger, a slap shot goes past the near side post. Gulf Coast will intercept that slap pass. At the red line, they will dump it in on goal, stick to the far side. Rebound settled down by Gulf Coast, and they will have possession in their offensive zone. Back behind the net, Barger will settle it down because Gulf Coast was able to make a pair of line changes. And now this pass is going to be gloved down, almost intercepted by Gulf Coast. Intended for Faller, and he gets it into the far side corner, allowing Riddle to make their wholesale line change. Good back check there from Brantley Miller. He intercepts that centering pass and gains the Gulf Coast blue line. Dumps it in and now knocks down his man. And now they're going to battle back in the zone. There's a bunch of players behind the play. There's going to be a penalty on this play.
Not sure who the call's against right now.
I believe it's going to be against Brantley Miller. There was an official with his arm up. It may have been for the icing play. The way this two officials, one linesman works, the official can have his arm up for just an icing play. So I don't think there's going to be a penalty on this play. But what could have been called was Brantley Miller coming in and stumbling into the Gulf Coast goaltender, Michael Kirch, That's not going to be called. We stay 5-on-5 with 5 minutes and 50 seconds left in the second period.
Riddle just registered their first shot on net in quite some time.
I would say in about, 13 minutes? They haven't gotten a shot since the first 2 minutes of this period.
I don't think you'd be wrong in saying that. Looked like it was a point shot from Bart, which was easily taken care of by Kirch.
And you can almost see Michael Kirch getting bored, for a lack of a better term. He's starting to play the puck a lot more, and that's what caused that collision just a couple seconds ago. But he is becoming a lot more aggressive in playing the puck anytime it gets within 10 feet of him. Gulf Coast will skate it down the near side boards. Toe drag works off the stick of Matruska. After he gained the blue line, it's sent all the way back down by Embry Riddle. And it's going to be Diaz to send it up the boards. Pass on the tape for Mullallin. Saucer pass knocked down out of midair. Gulf Coast comes into the slot. Loose puck and a shot is stopped by the stick of Colin Bridges. At the blue line, Gulf Coast keeps it in, and a shot was fanned on, looking for a turnaround pass. And no one was expecting it, so this one's going to be sent all the way down the ice. And an icing play will be called against Embry Riddle with 4:53 left in the second. Shots 36-17 in favor of Gulf Coast. 7-1 lead on the scoreboard for Florida. Gulf Coast with possession off the faceoff. It's going to be Malcolm. Sends it into the middle, regains possession, and he will leave it for Lundqvist. Lundqvist off the boards to the blue line for Perez. His shot gets deflected, and it gets through off the pad of Kim. At the blue line, it will come out into the neutral zone, and Rama will settle it down through a forecheck. That came from Malcheski. That puck comes all the way in on goal for Kirch, so it will negate the icing play. Saucer passes all the way through, doesn't connect, and we'll see who wins the race. It's going to be Malcolm away from Barger. And now Barger looks like he's limping off the ice. He may have squished his hand along the boards after taking that check from Kirch. He makes his way to the bench, and a shot comes in where Kim hangs onto the puck for a whistle. That's going to be a huge loss for Embry Riddle if team captain Barger is going to be out for the rest of this game.
Looks like team medic is Harry is looking at Barger over to see if he can help alleviate the noticeable pain he's in.
And it was immediate. As soon as he took that check, it wasn't a head hit. It wasn't a nasty hit from Malcolm. It just looked like it may have sent Barger's hand or wrist into the boards at an awkward angle that may have sprained it a little bit. So Gulf Coast in their own zone will send it out into neutral ice. And here comes Tremblay down the far side boards, throws it into the middle, through the legs of the Riddle player, and a pass gets through. And it will be settled down by Riddle in the near corner. On the far side, Usiak can't clear it out. Finally, on the second effort, they still can't clear it out. And it's going to be Nulon with a fourth attempt to get it out. He can't do it. Gulf Coast still has it. Pass in front, looking for a one-timer, was Connor Black, and it was too far in front of him for any quality chance. This one's going to be gloved down. No hand pass. It's going to be played by Hartman. Hartman cuts into the middle. Good stick there from Barton. Forces the puck to the far side. Huge collision on the far side. Barton finished his man along the boards, but he gives up the puck in the middle of the blue line. And Gulf Coast is going to take a very undisciplined penalty. It's going to be number 26, Connor Black, who didn't like the hit that Barton gave him. Came right back, took the feet out from underneath of Barton. And it will be an Embry Riddle power play with 2:45 left in the second. And if Riddle wants to get anything going, they haven't scored at all. They've barely had, five shots in this second period. This is going to be their best chance to get something going into the third period.
It was definitely a foolish penalty there by number 26. A no-need penalty. Let's see if Embry Riddle can make the pay for it.
It will be 5-on-4 on ice strength in favor of Embry-Riddle for the next 2 minutes. At the blue line, Barger, good to see him back out on the ice. He gets that pass on the near side, sends it off the boards. No one is there. Gulf Coast will send it back at the blue line where Barger will settle it down. Walks in ever so slightly, comes into the near corner for Marks. Marks will get it back in the near corner. He's got Barger at the blue line, sends it down low, and it will come back up for Barger. Goes through his legs, and Riddle is going to have to settle it down in their own zone. Behind the back, passes on the tape for Ebner. He circles back in his own zone, waiting for reinforcements. Everybody's on his left side, and reading that play well was David Cross, realizing that everybody was on this one side. He was able to intercept that play. And now Gulf Coast out of their own zone, throws it up into the ceiling. We'll see where they put this face off. It looks like it's going to stay in the neutral zone.
Looks like Marks and Barger are having a lot of talking there, seeing if they can work out something on this breakout, because not a lot has been happening so far.
Faceoff gets through Ebner, and he settles it down in his own zone, comes near side for Brendan Barger. Marks evading a couple of checks, leaves it for Ebner over the red line. No stick was on the ice for Riddle, so it comes onto the tape of Gulf Coast. They will send it over to the far side, deflected into the Embry-Riddle defensive zone. Good reverse play, pass comes on the tape for Barger. Barger backhands it up the far boards for Marks. Marks over the blue line, fakes the stop at the half wall, now stops up at the goal line, comes up top for Barger, takes a slap shot, pad save, was made by Kirch. And now a shorthanded chance possibly for Gulf Coast. Barger with a good back check will force it back behind the net where Marks will settle it down with 30 seconds to go in the Embry-Riddle power play. Marks over on the far side boards, comes in over the blue line, fails on the toe drag, but he gets it right back in the slot, and a backhander was stopped by the stick of Kirch. And this one's going to be sent the length of the ice by Florida Gulf Coast. Kim is going to have to play this, and he will do so nicely to the near side for Faller. Faller one touches into the middle, and Suzitsky will gain the Gulf Coast zone. We're back to 5-on-5 play with 40 seconds to go in the period. Pass into the middle, and a poor step up there from Barton. And Kim is all the way out to force this out of danger. Loses his stick in the process, but he gave up the body to force the puck to the far side, and a shot goes through the legs of Barton. And it is now an 8-1 lead for Gulf Coast.
Great play by Kim to get the puck out at first, but unfortunately, the team wasn't able to clear completely, and they capitalized.
And I don't want to make excuses for Barton or Kim, but it looked like Barton had given up his stick to Kim, as defensemen should be doing for their goaltender, but it went right through the legs of Barton because he didn't have a stick, and it looked like it went right through the pads of Kim because he didn't have his thick paddle. So you don't want to make excuses in an 8-1 game. That's not going to be the difference maker, but a play that should never have happened by Barton stepping up in the neutral zone like that.
Definitely a tough play for the Eagles at this point with only 21 seconds remaining in the period.
Barger sends it around the far side board. Solomon holds it along the half wall, tries to get it out, can't do so. Gulf Coast rims it around with 5 seconds to go in the period. Barger rims it back to the near side. Intercepted by Gulf Coast, and that'll be the end of the period. Shots 38-18 in favor of Gulf Coast, and they lead 8-1 over Embry-Riddle. Not a lot to be too excited about if you're an Embry-Riddle fan in that period. Only 6 shots registered in that second period.
FGCU definitely showing why they're consistently a national contender. Smooth passing, a lot of chances, and a lot of conversions.
We will be back for the start of the third period shortly here from the Daytona Ice Arena. set an open course. Welcome back, ladies and gentlemen, live inside the Daytona Ice Arena as we get set for the start of the third and final period here between the visiting Florida Gulf Coast Eagles and the hometown Embry-Riddle University Eagles. Gulf Coast is going to come into this third period leading by a score of an astounding 8-1 lead. They have chased starting goaltender Nico Prullier out of the net. Mitchell Kim will be his replacement. And not too many things to be optimistic about after that second period.
It was definitely a tough period for Riddle. They came out of the first looking a little bit like they had some life, and then FGCU definitely squashed a lot of that. We'll see how they can come back here in the third. Ooh.
Gulf Coast trying to pick right back up where they left off on a shot right off the opening faceoff that didn't miss the crossbar by much. Marks is going to try to change the tide a little bit. He's the lone goal scorer for Embry-Riddle tonight. And an errant pass will allow Embry-Riddle to come back into the zone. Fowler stops up at the blue line, backhand into the high slot. Gulf Coast will get it right back out into the neutral zone. Sent back into the Gulf Coast end, but again it's thrown all the way down into the Riddle defensive end. Barger's going to have to play this away from a no icing play.
For reference, it looks like Ryan Knapp he took a shot earlier. He's on the bench before. We weren't sure if he was going to come back for the third period, but it looks like he is on the bench.
Glad to hear that, as Embry-Riddle will start their breakout. An errant pass doesn't connect, and it will be played by Gulf Coast. Number 5, Blake Hartman. He will send a pass that's intercepted by Embry-Riddle. Barger will send it back into Gulf Coast territory. They work on their end zone regroup. And they found a wet patch of ice, but they will settle it down behind their own goal line. Pass gets intercepted, thrown up into the air. And Embry-Riddle sends it into their own bodies as this one sent into the near corner. Pace has definitely been slowed down from the first and second period. Gulf Coast trying to get out of their zone. They will. They got a 3-on-2 back the other way. Good speed, cuts right in, fires a shot over the crossbar. That was again number 16, Cody Tremblay, who has been showcasing his speed all night long. Good step up at the blue line by Miller. That'll force the puck out into the neutral zone. Still under Gulf Coast possession. And it's going to be Tremblay again. Drops a pass, and a shot gets deflected behind the goal line. At the blue line, kept in by Gulf Coast. Good passing play down low, and a shot gets stopped by the stick of Kirsten. Near side again for Gulf Coast. At the blue line they come. Long shot, missed wide of the net.
Looking like an FGCU power play out there, to be honest.
Finally, Embry-Riddle with possession. They'll get it out into the neutral zone, and they'll get it into the zone. Here comes Sakala, cuts in with a shot that went wide of the net. And Gulf Coast goes right back to work. They'll send this pass too far ahead. And Ryan Knapp will win the race to the dots on this icing play. And the faceoff will come all the way back down into the Gulf Coast defensive end.
Definitely touched on the fact that it's definitely a slower pace. Seems that both teams have kind of settled into this the mojo of where the game is at. They look to be just trying to finish it relatively calmly.
Loose puck at the top of the circle is finally going to be sent down below the goal line by Embry-Riddle. Gulf Coast trying to make a few line changes. And Gulf Coast will send this the length of the ice. It will be another icing play. And these frequent whistles don't help the slow pace. Still 17-10 left in the third period. That sees Gulf Coast leading 8-1. Face off on the near side circle. Embry-Riddle will win it, but Gulf Coast will steal possession away at the blue line. Barger steps up with help from Solomon. They'll get it right back into the zone. Solomon's thrown into the boards. He takes his man down. Solomon's thrown down now. Solomon's taken down from behind. And now we got a 2-on-2 battle. The linesman will come in and steer people away from that. That is Solomon and Horvat, along with Jacobo Perez. Horvat and Perez harassing Solomon down on the ice.
Perhaps I spoke too soon about this game ending relatively peacefully.
Still got a lot of hockey left to be played. I believe these two penalties will cancel out. I believe we're going to see some four-on-four hockey for the next 2 minutes. 2 minutes up on the board for Solomon, for Henry Riddle. And 2 minutes up on the board for number 10, Jacobo Perez for Gulf Coast. 16:54 left in the third period, 8-1 lead for Gulf Coast. Four-on-four play, a little bit more open ice for the Eagles, or for Henry Riddle, rather, to try to stretch the ice out a little bit. Linesman working on a patch in the ice that he feels is inadequate to be played on right now. Looks like they get that taken care of, and we're set to go on the far side circle in Gulf Coast defensive territory. At least I thought he deemed the ice surface adequate. Looks like now we're finally set to go. 2 minutes of four-on-four hockey is up on the clock and ready to go. Puck is down, and this one's going to be sent all the way down. High stick down by Barger, but Gulf Coast is going to play it. Great diving play by Barger. Stops that centering pass. Embry Riddle comes right back on the counterattack. Bouncing puck goes past the far side post. Gulf Coast gets it out. It's a one-on-one. Here comes Mulholland working one-on-one on Barger, and that's a tough defenseman to try to go one-on-one against. Barger keeps him to the outside. No shot was had, and Embry Riddle gets it out into the neutral zone. Thrown back in at the red line by Gulf Coast. They make a three-man line change. Barger reverses to the far side for Ebner. Ebner in the far side corner sends it back behind the net for Barger. Off the near side boards, and Embry Riddle will try to throw it at the red line into the Gulf Coast zone, and they will. Back behind the net, Papilla will gain speed out from behind his own net, skates down the far side boards, cuts around Ryan Marks, leaves it at the top of the circle. Gulf Coast trying to get something going on the four-on-four, and Embry Riddle will throw this one up into the rafters for a whistle with 49 seconds left on the four-on-four, 15:43 left in the third period. Faceoff will be on the near side circle in the Embry Riddle defensive end. Barton throws it up the near boards. Kept in by Gulf Coast at the half wall. Riddle with another chance to clear it out, can't do so. Gulf Coast walks into the slot. Save is made by Mitchell Kim, but he doesn't cover up the rebound. And it is going to be number 23, Jake Vero, who puts the ninth goal on the board for Gulf Coast.
Seemed to be like there was a little activity after the whistle between Barton and one of the FGCU players as they both go to the box.
Barton will make his way into the Embry Riddle penalty box, and number 24, Ben Corley, will go in for Gulf Coast. And I don't believe this will take the on-ice strength down to 3-on-3. I think we'll stay 4-on-4, and these will just be coincidental minors that stay off the board. So I believe we're going to stay 4-on-4 for the next 33 seconds. And then Barton and I believe that was Corley, they will come out after 2 minutes of play and a whistle. So we will not see them until the 13:27 mark and a whistle. Gulf Coast on the ensuing faceoff after scoring their ninth goal. They have possession at their own blue line. They'll send it up to the red line. And it will be sticked away by Laps. Marks comes in for support, but he can't stop the puck from going up to the blue line for Papilla. Papilla looking for that centering pass in the high slot. Doesn't find it. And Gulf Coast settles it down at the blue line, comes near side for Hartman. Hartman behind the Embry-Riddle net. We're back to 5-on-5 play. Far corner pass comes up to the near blue line, and now players coming together again at the blue line. And Blake Hartman not doing too much chirping other than pointing at the scoreboard, letting, I believe that's Ryan Marks, who is now helmetless in front of his Embry-Riddle bench. Marks doing most of the chirping across the red line.
FGCU players pointing at the scoreboard and tapping the boards a bit. Definitely enjoying that.
And right now, you got to think Embry-Riddle's got to send a message for tomorrow afternoon's game. Matchup right back here at 4:30 tomorrow. Same two teams, same sheet of ice. And right now, Embry-Riddle's just trying to send a message that they're not going to be embarrassed both on the scoreboard and physically at this point.
There's most likely a lot of conversations that we'll see tomorrow.
Ebner is unable to clear the puck for Embry-Riddle. Two-a-side battle back behind the net. Gulf Coast will have possession thanks to Malcolm.
Looks like Captain Brendan Barger has left the bench and is going back to the locker room. Not a good sign.
At the blue line, Diaz sends it back down low into the Embry-Riddle defensive end. Gulf Coast has it below the goal line. Stolen away by the stick of Colin Bridges, gets up to the blue line and eventually to the neutral zone. Again, settled down by Alfonso Diaz. He takes a tumble at the blue line, gives the puck up to Sakala. He takes a shot that's stopped by a diving Gulf Coast player. That was, again, Diaz. And I believe that was number 14, Greg Steinmetz, who was pushed into the Gulf Coast net. And that brings a faceoff in the Gulf Coast zone, where we'll see if they take it out of the zone because it was Gulf Coast who was pushed into it, and that's what it's going to be. We're going to have a faceoff out in the neutral zone with 14:01 left in the third period. Still 5-on-5 play.
Does not look like Embry-Riddle has established a shot on goal in this period.
Some more pushing and shoving in the neutral zone will allow Gulf Coast to gain the neutral zone. With possession at the red line, they have it off a couple of spin moves at the blue line. They gain the Riddle zone. Huge collision there as Brantley Miller ran his man in the trolley tracks. Sakala is unable to get around his man in the far boards. And that will allow Gulf Coast to send it to the red line, only as far as that. And it's going to be gloved down by Sakala. He evades a couple of checks, but he yields possession to Gulf Coast. Saucer pass almost intercepted by Sakala, and Gulf Coast comes into the Embry-Riddle zone. Near side blue line comes up for Gulf Coast. Goes far side looking for a shot, and now we have some pushing and shoving on the near side. And that's all that's going to come from that. Players are going to gather in a huddle, but that's going to be the only thing that comes from it. Referees doing a good job of making sure that no actual fisticuffs occur.
And you can't help but wonder what this game would be like if a few fights are allowed to happen.
You can only imagine, and realistically, everybody has to wear a full face mask, so there has to be kind of this whole setup. And now Gulf Coast is going to use their timeout. I can only imagine that the Florida Gulf Coast coaches are reminding their players that they still got to play tomorrow. They can't get caught in whatever Embry-Riddle's trying to do to knock them off their game. And the Gulf Coast coach is pointing at the scoreboard saying, we have the lead, play smart, or you're going to be thrown off the ice, is the message that I'm gathering and the hand signals that I'm seeing. Meanwhile, the Embry-Riddle coaching staff letting them know that, hey, there's a game tomorrow. You got to send that message. 13:12 left in the third period, and it looks like Sakala is going to be the only player penalized, so it's going to be a 5-on-4 power play for Gulf Coast.
Gulf Coast has definitely controlled the pace of the game, but has not shied away from taking matters into their own hands and
Physically, it's been a very evenly matched game. Both teams have laid some hits, taken some hits, but scoreboard possession and just all-around passing and puck movement has been all Gulf Coast tonight.
There's not been a doubt in that since the first puck drop.
Faceoff will be in the Embry-Riddle zone on the near side. It is a 5-on-4 power play for Gulf Coast. Not sure what the actual penalty call was against Sakala, but he is the one serving the 2-minute minor.
Quite surprised that no Gulf Coast player got a penalty on that play.
Referee sending a message here in this third period that they're not going to take both. No matter what the score is, they're going to put one team down. Gulf Coast escaping out the near side of the net on their set power play breakout. They move it to the far side, and here comes Tremblay with speed again. Pass into the high slot, loose puck in the crease, careens to the far corner. Pass comes to the near side, looking for a play down low, reverses over a couple of bodies, and now another careless penalty is going to come against Embry-Riddle. This time it's going to be Faller. Faller is going to get a tripping penalty after getting his feet tied up with Jacobo Perez, and Embry-Riddle is going to be down 5-3 for the next minute and 26 seconds.
This could be an opportunity for Gulf Coast to continue to put salt to the wound.
Gulf Coast looking for double digits on the scoreboard. They lead 9-1 with 12:37 left in the third. Gulf Coast will win the faceoff. Pass comes up to the blue line for Mullallin. Blue line again goes far side. One-timer blocked in front. Marks can't clear it out. Near side again for Mullallin. Up at the blue line for Diaz. Far side again. Diaz wants the one-timer. He's not going to get it. Great shot block from Barger. He has the puck, and he will send it the length of the ice. Off the boards, Michael Kirch will settle it down. We are 8 minutes into this third period, and Kirch has not seen a single shot faced against him. Gulf Coast will gain the zone through the stick of Ryan Marks. They will send it back down low. Spin move is on against Barger, works on him. And Gulf Coast has it in the near corner. Ben Corley will send it up to the blue line for Fitzgerald. Fitzgerald walks in, takes a shot, deflected, and a six save was made by Mitchell Kim. Blue line again, Gulf Coast with a shot, once again blocked by Marks. 25 seconds left until we're back to 5-on-4.
A lot of credit to be given to these penalty killers out there, giving their body despite the score. Lots to be said.
Fitzgerald again with a shot. Didn't have a clear shooting lane. As you said, Ryan Marks was in the shooting lane, sacrificing that body. Blue line pass was on the near side tape. And another sharp angle shot. Blocker save made by Kim. Loose in the crease, and it settled down on the far side. 5-on-4. Shot goes wide of the near side post. Comes to the near corner. And another shot patted away by Kim. Puck is still loose, thrown into the crease. Embry-Riddle with a chance to clear, and they will do so. 20 seconds left on their penalty kill. Thrown off the boards by Kirch.
What a play.
All the way down, and Embry-Riddle unable to keep Gulf Coast out of the zone on their power play.
That was an amazing play by Vero to keep his feet.
Over on the far side, we're finally back to 5-on-5 play. Great penalty kill from Embry-Riddle. But Gulf Coast is not done with the pressure. They send it up to the near side blue line. Kept in by Gulf Coast, rimmed around the boards, kept in again, walks into the high slot, drop pass there. Shot comes into the crease, glove save made by Mitchell Kim on a diving effort moving from his right to left, making a huge glove save, making his presence felt despite the score.
Incredible save. I mean, a lot of credit, tip your hat to the Gulf Coast puck movement on that power play, and even after, to create that amazing opportunity. Great sprawling save by Kim.
So everyone is out of the penalty box. We are back to 5-on-5 play with 10:20 left in the third period. Embry-Riddle with possession off the faceoff. They will send it into the penalty box area. That will keep the faceoff in the Embry-Riddle zone.
Tough break for Richard Means on that clear, just trying to get the puck out and unfortunately putting it over the glass.
Gulf Coast with possession off the next faceoff, looking for a backhand shot, finds one, and it just misses the far post. Embry-Riddle again unable to clear it out. Over on the far side, it's going to be Lundqvist to settle it down. Lundqvist at the blue line, shot gets blocked in front. Embry-Riddle will get it out. Marks is unable to get around his man at the blue line. That's Usiak, rather, who has the puck stripped away from him as he gained the Gulf Coast blue line. Malcolm has it for Gulf Coast. He's got a man on the far side, but he goes for the stretch pass. Misses everybody, and this will be an icing play. He had a safe play on the far side, but he went for the dangerous stretch pass, and it will cost his team an icing play with 9:37 left in the third.
A rare faceoff in the Gulf Coast end for this period.
Halfway through this period, Embry-Riddle still looking for their first shot on goal this period. Shots 44-18 in favor of Gulf Coast.
It's definitely been a tough period offensively for the Eagles, for the Embry-Riddle Eagles, that is.
Gulf Coast will win the faceoff, not allowing Embry-Riddle to get a shot off that faceoff. Just like that, Gulf Coast will exit their zone, and it looks like a fresh sheet of ice. It looks like that the Zamboni just never left the ice in the Gulf Coast defensive end. It has all been scraped up in the Embry-Riddle defensive end as this bouncing puck came into the glove hand of Mitchell Kim. Faceoff will be in the Embry-Riddle defensive zone on the near side circle. Quick shot off the faceoff, and that was blocked in front by Colin Bridges. Over to the far corner, Bridges again has it. He will clear it all the way down, looking for an icing call, but it's not gonna make it. Play is gonna continue. Gulf Coast will stop up behind their net thanks to Tom Rama. Pass through the legs of Connor Black. He gains the neutral zone, and at the red line, he will dump it into the Embry-Riddle defensive end. Bridges loses the battle, and he will yield possession to Cohen. Cohen with a pass into the high slot gets deflected, but it reaches the tape of a few Gulf Coast players. One too many passes as they didn't get a shot off in the high slot. Pass in front, good stick there.
By Ryan Knapp.
From Ryan Knapp, he was able to stop that centering pass.
Good to see Knapp on the ice and playing at 100%. I was worried about him earlier with that shot he took off, the upper part of his left foot.
Shot from the blue line gets deflected up into the netting for a whistle with 8:25 left in the third. Still a 9-1 lead for Gulf Coast. Embry-Riddle, right now you're just looking for your first shot of the period. Right now that would be the moral victory for Embry-Riddle. You got to get at least one shot on goal in the next couple of minutes at least.
It's definitely continuing to be a statement from Gulf Coast that they have not yielded over 20 shots in this game at all, and none in the past 12 minutes.
Gulf Coast will send it into the Embry-Riddle zone off a deflected pass at the red line. Reverse pass is read by Mulholland, and he has possession for Gulf Coast, evading the check of a couple of white jerseys, but gets possession to Faller. Pass comes right through the stick of Barger, and he settles it down on the near side boards, throws it off the glass and out of the zone. Saucer passes gloved down by Horvat, and he will gain the Embry-Riddle zone. Unable to get a shot off, and this one comes right in where Mitchell Kim will cover a rolling puck for a whistle with 7:49 left in the third period.
Nice job of taking the body on that play, allowing the puck to dribble in on Kim for a quick freeze.
Faceoff will be on the far side circle. Marks will lose it, and Gulf Coast again with a quick shot gets deflected into the glove of Kim, and he hangs on for a whistle. Shots now 47-18 still in favor of Gulf Coast.
Still actively looking to put traffic in front. T from the point, looking to get the double digits on the scoreboard.
Gulf Coast has not let up at all. Very easy for a team, even up two or three goals, to get complacent with the score. But Gulf Coast up 9-1 has not let their foot off the gas.
Definitely sending a statement in their first game of the 2018-19 season.
Over on the far side, Mulholland tries to throw it in front, but it gets deflected to the near side. At the blue line, a long shot comes into the glove hand of Kim. There was no screen in front, So it's a routine catch made by Kim for a whistle. After what was a capacity crowd here through the first two periods, it has since dwindled down to just about a row or two up here in the upper deck along the glass.
Still seems to be a solid couple rows downstairs, though, but definitely less than when we started this broadcast.
Embry Riddle's able to get it out into the neutral zone. They'll come in over the blue line, or I thought they were going to. They stopped up and retreated back into the neutral zone, and at the red line, they will dump it in. Michael Kirch getting one more touch of the puck after not seeing any shots this period, and here's a 2-on-1 for Gulf Coast. Down the near side, a pass comes into the middle, and it went just past the far post. And now we have a dangerous situation here as Mitchell Kim was run into by a sliding defender. Not sure who that was, diving back to try to stop the 2-on-1. But it was Mitchell Kim who got the brunt of that body. It's number 71, Jeremy Kirsten. Mitchell Kim is up on his knees, ever so gingerly, however.
Does seem to be in some distress based on what we can see from facial expressions up here.
Still 6:43 left to go in this third period. We'll see if Prouliere has to come back in. Kim is being attended to by the team trainer. He has made his way up onto his feet. And he looks like he's going to be good to continue this game. He grabs a swig of water. And he will don that goalie mask one more time to show that he is ready to get going here.
Definitely a close call for Kim, who has had a history with getting issues like that with his hip. So glad to see that he's up and moving. Not too much difficulty.
But again, if you're Gulf Coast, who hasn't let their foot off the gas, they're just going to fire shot after shot after shot after seeing a goaltender go down like that.
It's a good thing Kim is one of the more flexible goalies on the team.
And now we got to wait for Embry Riddle to get one more player out. And it will be Usiak to finish out the five-man unit for Embry Riddle. Gulf Coast will win the faceoff. They'll send it down to the high slot. Back down to the far corner. Sends it up to the blue line for Papilla. Walks into the middle, takes a check doing so. He sent his man down to the ice. That was Ben Malcheski,
who
absolutely ran through his man at the blue line and got the puck out at the same time. Solomon with a shot that went wide of the net. Still not an official registered shot on goal yet for Embry Riddle, but they have some life in their offensive zone.
Now Chesky's on a tear this shift with three solid hits.
Solomon with possession in the near corner, tries to reverse for Malcheski. Comes up to the blue line and a shot gets deflected away. Embry Riddle still looking for a shot, and a slashing call is gonna come against Solomon.
Tough break for the for Embry Riddle. Earlier in the shift, Malcheski had a great couple hits. Looked like he had been tripped on the way in to the FGCU zone with no call. And unfortunately, Solomon gets called for a pretty obvious slash.
It was an obvious slash, and it is going to be an Embry Riddle penalty kill with 5:53 left in the third period. So probably the best shift for Embry Riddle in this third period. Still doesn't register a shot. And we're almost three quarters of the way through this third and final period.
A lot of credit to Malcheski on an excellent shift, though. Definitely generating a lot of energy, a lot of buzz. Easily seeing how three solid hits put FGCU in their own zone. Riddle again trying to avoid double digits on the board for FGCU.
Pass comes right through the crease after it got deflected, and it comes to the near corner, thrown to the far side. Looking for a pass into the slot, stymied there by Barger. Forces the puck up the wall to the blue line. Walking into the middle, and a pass comes back to the half wall. Pass into the middle, and it was fanned on by Malcolm. Back behind the net, behind Kim. Pass gets deflected by the skate of Ebner. Gulf Coast still has possession. throws it up to the blue line for Perez. Back down for Lundqvist. Malcolm has it at the blue line, back for Lundqvist. Lundqvist looking for a pass for Malcolm, but it's stopped by Embry-Riddle, but it's kept into the zone by Gulf Coast. Lundqvist again sends it down low for Malcolm. Looks for a pass to the far side, gets deflected, kept in at the blue line, barely. Gulf Coast with possession down low below the goal line again. Blue line again for Perez. His shot comes right into the midsection for a standing save made by Kim.
Active shift for Ebner, getting the stick in the way two times. Definitely doing a good job of making it difficult for FGCU to execute the pass as they want.
50 seconds left in the Embry-Riddle penalty kill. 4:43 left in the third period. That sees Gulf Coast leading by a score of 9-1.
Incredible that Embry-Riddle has still been unable to register a shot.
Give credit where credit's due. Embry-Riddle doing the best they can. At least I say the best they can for tonight's effort. This has been one of the honestly worst games I've seen this season. They had a strong statement against the University of Miami, both at home and on the road. And then once they hit UCF a couple of weeks ago, that was a tough loss there at RDV, and now they're just honestly getting manhandled by a very strong Gulf Coast team.
No knock to this Embry-Riddle team, though. This team has a lot of heart, absolutely. They've been working hard, big steps from where they have been in the past few years.
And I have not seen a single player quit with 4:19 left in the third period, but it is going to be Barton again going into the box alongside number 28, Craig Fitzgerald.
That's a statement to every one of the Embry-Riddle players as well as the coaching staff, continuing to instill in a good work ethic and a commitment to excellent play.
So it's still a 5-on-4 penalty kill for 26 seconds for Embry-Riddle. Faceoff will be in their defensive zone. March will win the faceoff back. And Knapp will send it around the near side. Puck comes into the middle. Ryan Marks looking for his second goal of the night, comes in, looking for a shot. He trips over the red line, and still no shot registered in the third period for Embry-Riddle. Gulf Coast comes back on the counterattack, and a shot comes in, stopped in front. Marks fails on the toe drag, and it's kept into the Embry-Riddle zone, but we are back to 5-on-5 play. Faller forces the puck up to the blue line, pass gets deflected by the stick of Tremblay. And this one kept in at the blue line again. Far side, Tremblay, a one-timer. He didn't get any of it, but he has possession below the goal line. Pass off the outside of the net, and it's sent around the far side boards by Bridges. Kept in by Papilla. Bouncing puck gets deflected wide of the far post.
Looks like the net had been slightly dislodged.
May have been put back by Kim as this one's deflected to the far corner. Pass comes up at the blue line. Coming in is Gulf Coast. Sticked away. And Embry-Riddle will bring it back through the stick of Shepherd. This one goes wide of the post, and Kirch has to rim it around the far side boards. Gulf Coast gets it out to the neutral zone. Pass gets through the tape of Cohen. Comes right in on Kim. And Barger pushing the Gulf Coast player almost right into Kim. Forces him into the net, which dislodges it, and it'll bring a whistle with 2:55 left in the third.
Riddle doing a good job this period of, despite being hemmed in their own zone, not giving FGCU too many overwhelmingly high-quality scoring chances, keeping them wide, playing the body, getting the passing lanes. A lot of credit to be due there, as this has to be absolutely tiring for them.
Not a great offensive or very well breakout period for them, but you got to take some good from the bad. This has been an excellent defensive zone period for Embry-Riddle, as finally that should be the first registered shot for Embry-Riddle as it comes into the glove hand of Kirch, and he hangs on for a whistle. But as I was saying, you got to look, when they look at this film back, they're going to look at this third period and say, Gulf Coast had so much zone time and so much possession. I would say now with 2:38 left, I would say about 16 to 15 minutes of this game has been in the Embry-Riddle zone, and they've kept Gulf Coast to one goal this period. That's got to be some positive that you got to take from this kind of a game.
Absolutely, and for a team looking to continue to grow, as this team has made massive strides in the past few years, you can look at that and say, wow, look how far we've come in just a handful of years.
Obviously, we can always find things to work on, but in a game like this, it's hard to find things to look at positively, and they just have to keep reinforcing everything there. Is now this is going to draw a crowd. Barger sends his man down to the ice after a snow shower came from Kyle Horvath on Kim. And now we have a crowd in the far corner. And we'll see what penalties come from this. It was Horvat who came in on an unnecessarily close play on Mitchell Kim, giving him a snow shower, completely unnecessary, and that will force Merrick Sizitsky and Brendan Barger and Brantley Miller into the Embry-Riddle penalty box.
That seems a bit excessive.
Three white jerseys in the Embry-Riddle penalty box, and I only see one blue jersey in the penalty box. Referees are still talking it over. There's no time up on the board yet. You hope to see at least one of these Embry-Riddle players. I can't imagine how the referees would give a 3-1 penalty advantage to Gulf Coast.
Did not seem that way at all.
On a play that started because Gulf Coast came in on a hard play.
A not hard shot.
There was no rebound. Mitchell Kim had it the entire way. And just an unnecessary snow shower in his face. And Barger was just standing up for his goaltender. And I don't even see Kyle Horvath in the penalty box at all. And he was the one who started all this. It's number 20, Max Mulholland, who is taking a seat in the Gulf Coast penalty box.
Not sure why he's in the box either. Must have missed that.
But now with 2:14 left in the third period, this is almost prolonging the inevitable.
Giving FGCU several opportunities to expand on their goal count, bring it to the double digits as they've been trying to all period. Embry-Riddle hoping to keep it to simply single digits.
So Sizitsky has made his way out of the penalty box. And he has gone onto the bench. 2 minutes is up on the board for Embry-Riddle. And I believe that's all we're going to see on the board. I think it's going to be a 5-on-4 power play for Gulf Coast. I'm not even saying that Gulf Coast should be on the penalty kill. I would think that this should even out. I saw the snow shower in front and players coming together on both sides.
You have no disagreement from me, Nick.
And I would assume the other two cancel out. So we are 5-on-4, three total penalties. I would assume they're all roughing penalties. As this shot comes in from the blue line and a rocket came in. And a pass comes all the way up to the blue line, kept in by Papilla. Papilla, a knuckle puck comes into the glove hand of Kim and he hangs on for a whistle with 1:45 left in the third. And now with Embry-Riddle being on the penalty kill for the rest of the game except for about 18 seconds, that shot count of zero is looking very solid for Gulf Coast right now. In the high slot, Embry-Riddle trying to clear it out, can't do so. Papilla keeps it at the blue line, walks in, fires a shot that gets deflected up into the netting and out of play off the stick of Ben Malcheski.
Riddle's definitely in lockdown mode right now, just trying to run out the clock and the score as is, and take what they can from the game.
1:28 says the clock. Riddle will make a wholesale line change. Four fresh penalty killers out on the ice. Riddle will win the faceoff. They will send it the length of the ice. Wide of the net, Riddle still only with one shot in this entire third period, with the clock winding down to 1:15 left in the period. Gulf Coast will gain the blue line, but that's as far as they'll get. Sticked away by Ryan Knapp into the Gulf Coast zone. Faller with good forecheck pressure. He's knocked down on the play on a good clean hit. And Gulf Coast will come right back on a counterattack. Ben Corley down the far side boards, gets around his man, and he's met on the boards by Ryan Marks. Rolling puck gets shot wide of the near side post. 45 seconds to go in the game. Out the far side, rolling puck in the crease is sent off the glass, kept in at the blue line. Rolling slap shot goes to the far corner. Back behind the net, Gulf Coast has it, still looking for double digits, but they only have 30 seconds to get it. Pass comes up to the blue line. Fitzgerald walks in, fires a shot, deflected, and it's right there on the goal line. No goal call from the official, and I believe it's Ryan Knapp who stopped that puck on the goal line as it got through the legs of Mitchell Kim.
Giving Kim a little kiss and a tap, saying, I've got you. That's all we want from our defenseman.
Stopping the clock with 22.8 seconds. And it's about time that the goaltenders got some help from the defensemen. The only reason Nico Prullier is on the bench is because he got left out to dry for six goals against FGCU. But most of them were rebounds and second effort chances. And it's good to see that the defense stepping up at this point of the game.
Showing effort all the way through, playing a full 60 minutes under Riddle is now.
Gulf Coast out from the near side of the net. At the blue line, walking in, and a shot gets blocked. On the near side with a shot, rings the pipe. 5 seconds left. Gulf Coast really wants that 10th goal, but it doesn't look like they're going to get it, and a rolling puck will be settled down. Gulf Coast will come in, winning the first game of this two-game weekend here in Daytona. FGCU wins by a score of 9-1 over Embry-Riddle. And like we were saying, it's hard to take some positives out from a game like this, but what does Embry-Riddle look forward to in their 4:30 matchup tomorrow against the same FGCU squad?
I think it's looking at knowing that they played a hard, gritty game against this team, and that both sides are going to be feeling it tomorrow, and hoping that they can come out with some different energy, change the game a little bit from the beginning. It's all you can hope for against a team like this. A lot of respect to FGCU. They have a fantastic program, and Embry-Riddle's hoping to keep improving and progressing to make these games even closer every time they play.
Once again, final score here from the Daytona Ice Arena, FGCU 9, Embry-Riddle Aeronautical University 1. For Andrew Caputo, I'm Nick Gimbel. We thank you for joining us here on this Friday night matchup of ACHA hockey, and we will see you tomorrow afternoon at a 4:30 puck drop against these same two teams, Embry-Riddle versus Florida Gulf Coast, tomorrow at 4:30, right back here on YouTube.